Some materials. So I think I send you the link with some Dropbox. So in Dropbox, basically, I put this presentation. This presentation is like 62 slides, but I will not go through the 62 slides. It's as a presentation I did for Nubias Academy at home, like in May or June this year. So you have all the information there. You have also the video of my presentation. It was not really a tutorial. This time is more like hands-on. And you also have some question and answer about this presentation on the forum. And I'm very, and you can ask a lot of questions on the forum on a 3D image analysis or just image analysis in general. So please go to the forum. So just one, two words about why we start Image. We start like 2006 to analyze distances between gene looking in fluorescence in nuclei. So you see the two red dots. And we had like 1,000 images like this. And we wanted to get 3D accurate measurement because we realized that if we do 2D measurement on a projection, the measurement are wrong. The distances we measure is completely wrong. So we had to go 3D. And at that time in Image, it was a bit difficult to do batch processing for 3D images. So we decided to start building a library and some tools for 3D analysis. And also, of course, robust algorithm and also automation. So this is how we start. And we didn't think that 10 years later, we will still develop this thing and people will still use this thing for completely different. Some people are still using 3D imaging for nuclei, but also for completely different stuff. And we started with very small images, and now people can use 3D imaging for very big images. So we are quite happy about this. It's still working. So what is the 3D image suite? Actually, it's a set of algorithms for 3D processing, 3D analysis. So first, we package the algorithm into what we call a core. So it's a MCIB 3D core for people interested in programming. So these are the core algorithm. You cannot really use them directly. We need some plugins. The plugins will call the algorithm and so then produce a result. So we have the MCIB 3D plugins. And this plugin will just call the core algorithm. So basically we focus on a bit of processing, segmentation, analysis, and some miscellaneous utility tools. Everything is open source. You can download the core, the plugins, everything. Of course, we can do macro. We'll maybe focus more on macro than plugins. And then just to acknowledge people. So we started with Cedric, first PhD student, the first version, with Jean, the second version. For me, just a lot of supervision and maintenance. I would like to acknowledge some Philippe André. We did some spatial statistics, 2D and 3D spatial statistics with Philippe. And of course, all my wonderful PhD students, Cedric, Sébastien, Jean, Jaza, Oa, Lamis, and Afshin. And you can get all the information you want on this website. So maybe we will take 5 minutes to go to this website. So now I just switch to here and then, yep, yes. So this is the basic website. So Imagenet, so this is where there are a lot of information about Imagi new version. We are not talking about Imagi. This one was the previous classical legacy website. So now this is the modern website. And they still want to make like a post-modern website. I think I have here. So this one is the post-modern website. So it's a bit difficult for us to follow all this new website. So here you will find all the information you want. My some information about us. So all this Nebias Academy presentation, YouTube, the question, some link to tapas. So in the suite we started with filters, because first we need some filters. There was no 3D filters, so we had first to develop 3D filters. Then we focus a bit more on 3D segmentation. So maybe if we have time, we will just talk about spot segmentation, a bit of nucleus segmentation, iterative thresholding, watershed, this kind of thing. But now with deep learning, I'm sure you have registered for deep learning stuff. For 3D segmentation, yeah, maybe deep learning is better for segmentation. But with classical tools, you can already do a lot of nice segmentation. 3D mathematical morphology. Mathematical morphology, I think, is a French stuff. We like this kind of thing. It's like improving the segmentation. So you try to detect objects, but the objects are not, the detection is not perfect. So maybe you need to fill walls to open, to separate objects that are merging or touching, this kind of thing. And actually, of course, after you have 3D analysis, so this is maybe you try to focus more about this thing, like once you have detected your objects, 2D or 3D, here we are focusing on 3D, what kind of measurement can you do on your object? Of course, geometry, distances, colocalization, and so on and so on. 3D metrology is a bit, we'll see later. Some tools just to draw. So you can choose to draw an ellipsoid at a specific position in 3D, some cropping and so on and so on. And of course, a bit separated, spatial statistics tool. So to compute, are my my spots randomly distributed inside the area or not? So you need statistics to prove this. And we will focus on this thing, the ARI manager. So basically it's just a graphical interface. So you can get access to your object and get a measurement on your object and visualize them on delete. It's like editing your 3D object. So we will focus more on this thing.